There's nothing better than the smell of fresh baked bread on a cold winter's morning, and this morning we're experiencing it. The folks from Breadsmith in Ashwaubenon are here to show us how they make some of their amazing breads. This is Bruce Johnson. Good morning to you.
Good morning. Thank you for having us.
Yes. Why don't you take us through some of these breads that are already finished here?
Okay. What we have is some of our finished products sitting in front of us here. Start out with our sweets on the side, our cinnamon pull-aparts, our cinnamon breads for morning. These here, a number of our French breads, our loaves, our baguettes, our batards, the rolls, these mini baguettes. We even have soup bowls. And then we also have a few of our other breads, like our rye that we're featuring today.
And smells amazing. Take a look at that beautiful bread. Now the question is how do we get it to look that way? And that's what you're going to show us now.
Yeah, what we do in our shop, everything we have every day is baked fresh. And we make everything has no preservatives in it. So we're using the things we would use at homes. We have the yeast, the salt, and our flour. Mm-hmm. Mix that with water. Most of our breads have just those items in them. And then we go ahead and we have a dough, as we're having in front of us here.
Okay.
And then we make multiple different things with them. Obviously, we have different sizes here. So, for instance, we could start with the rolls.
Okay. What would you like me to do?
We make a 4-ounce roll.
Okay.
So the thing is to knead it, get it ready in your hand, and then to put it on the table.
Okay.
Kind of make a grip with your hand and roll it. You'll feel it start to grip, and it'll actually start to roll the dough.
Okay.
Okay. And then once we're done rolling it, you'll have a roll set up in front of you. Sometimes it won't quite stick so good, so you got to work them a little harder.
Okay. This is kind of fun. It's like a stress reliever.
Works very well that way.
Okay.
And you end up with... With a round roll.
Well, yours looks better than mine. Okay.
I've had a lot of practice. from there, we make the larger ones, which are the soup bowls, which we've seen over here before. Basically, it's just a larger piece of the dough,
mm-hmm.
and we roll it between our hands in this nature.
How long do you roll it? Well, is there a certain feeling or texture?
Yeah, you can feel it tighten up. And once it tightens up and it gets the nice round look to it, we're ready to go. At that point, the dough will be put into a proofer, where it will rise and get right to the right size that we need. At that point, our baker will then take and score the bread.
And that means?
Well, what we do is to take a razor like this, which is extremely sharp, and in this case, we're going to score it with an X on it.
So is it just kind of like for aesthetic purposes?
Two things. Actually, aesthetics is also a plus, but it breaks the seal on the outside of the dough. So it releases the moisture from the inside as the bread is baking, so it doesn't break apart and crack apart.
Okay.
It also gives us the idea of what actual bread that is. It's kind of a marker of the style of bread that we have,
because
mm-hmm. we make so many different styles every day.
And you can see the scores along this long piece.
Exactly. That's what they look like at the end.
Well. Wonderful.
Yep.
I know you're going to be sticking around with us this morning, and we're going to mm-hmm. be making some more bread. And you're going to put me to work again?
Absolutely.
I didn't do a very good job on that.
Absolutely.
Role.
On the second segment, we're going to do a little more with the finished product, and what we're going to end up, we'll have you cut some of the breads up, and we're going to make some bruschetta.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
That's one of my favorites.
Amongst some other items as well, so we're going to get that ready for that segment as well.
Looking forward to it. Thanks, Bruce.
Thank you.
We'll be right back. You're watching Good Day Wisconsin. Keep working on this.